Hi, this is Miss Marvy here, and I wanted to show you what I found at my door. It was in a box, and I unpacked it, and here's this robot. I don't know how to shut it off. I don't know why he's here.
Hello, Miss Marvy.
Hello?
I am Robbie the robot.
You are Robbie the robot? Well, that's nice. You're very handsome, but why are you here?
I'm here to help clean.
Help clean? Woohoo! That is great!
I do floors. I do dishes. I help clean.
Well, that's wonderful. I could really use the help cleaning. Well, maybe you're like that Roomba guy that does the floor.
I do more.
You do more? Wow! Well, if you do floors and dishes, maybe I should let you get started. I'm so glad you came. Who sent you?
A friend.
A friend? Well, I have to find out what friend sent me this great robot. I'm gonna let you get started. I could use help sweeping my floor.
Okay, see you later.
Oh my goodness. All right, well, I'll be very careful. And I'll just gonna put him right here on the floor. And if you hear anything, he's probably cleaning for me. Isn't that great? Well, today we're gonna talk about the letter R. R is for robot, so that's probably why my friend sent it, thinking I could share it with you for our day, but also I get something cleaned in my house. This is an uppercase R and a lowercase R. And behind me, I have some things that begin with R, like this. Uppercase R, lowercase R. And this is a rhinoceros. That's a big word. And this is a raincoat. Boy, I could use a new raincoat. This is a rock. And I have roller skates. Oh, I used to roller skate. I haven't so much. And it's raining. Well, that's why you need the raincoat. A raccoon. A rooster. And the rooster is on roller skates. Oh, silly. And there's the rose. So I'm gonna put that back here. But we are gonna talk about robots today. And I have a story for you about a robot. This is the name of the story. It's called Benjamin McFadden and the Robot Babysitter. There's the word robot in the title. And robots have helped us with many things. Robots used to help us with space exploration and still are helping us, but they do so many more things. Robots can help us in factories. Robots can help us on Mars. And I have a picture here to show you Mars. It's the red planet, and right now we have a kind of robot that is a rover who's taking pictures and sending them back. Another R word is rocket, and the rocket went to the moon a long time ago, and the rover helped to take pictures there. Mars is very far away, so it would be hard for people to go there. Plus, we can't breathe there. But lots of robots that go into space can tell us many things. Here are some other examples of robots in our stories. This is the black hole, and there are three robots there. One, two, three. And this is Droid War. If you've ever seen Star Wars, that's R2-D2 and C-3PO, and they were robots. So robots are good for many things, and I'm just so excited that my friend sent me a robot. And, oh, I have one here. My goodness. Here's another little robot for you to see. He's walking. At least he's trying to walk. I think he must be tired. So let's see if we can look at our story today, because we have lots of things to talk about. This is called Benjamin McFadden and the Robot Babysitter. The night his mother and father went out to the Rings of Saturn preservation dance, Benjamin McFadden and his kitten, Fantastic, were not invited to come along. Grown-ups only, his father said. And haven't you got homework in creative computing?
I hate that class, said Benjamin McFadden. I think my teacher is an alien spy.
But his parents flew off in their silver ship, and Benjamin McFadden was left alone with his terrible robot babysitter.
"Ain't o'clock Earth time," babysitter said. "My programming tells me that it's time for you to sleep."
"Programming's wrong," answered Benjamin McFadden. "I'm always allowed to stay up till 10.
"Bed," said babysitter.
"No," said Benjamin. But babysitter wouldn't take no for an answer. She's lifting him up with her long arm. Benjamin put his pajamas on. He put his pajamas on very slowly.
"Ain't 15 Earth time," babysitter said. "You are now in violation of your scheduled routine."
"May I have a cookie?" Benjamin asked.
"No," said babysitter. "Time for bed."
Benjamin folded his arms and said, "The trouble with you, babysitter, is that you are no fun."
Babysitter answered, "I'm not programmed for fun."
Benjamin McFadden said, "Well, we'll see about that. I wonder what he's gonna do." Benjamin opened up the panel on babysitter's back, which his parents had told him he should never, never do. He tried what he'd learned in creative computing class and reprogrammed babysitter to be more fun.
Ooh.
"What time is it, babysitter?" Benjamin asked.
"Ain't 20 Earth time," babysitter said. "My programming tells me that it's time for fun."
"Benjamin McFadden, what is fun?" Benjamin McFadden was so happy to explain what fun was. "Games," said Benjamin. "Games are fun, but two arms per play or it isn't fair," because the robot had lots of arms. Oh my goodness, look at that. "Books," said Benjamin. "Books are fun. They never need batteries. They fit in your knapsack, and when they get broken, you can fix them with tape." So there's lots of books. "Music," said Benjamin. "Music is fun. Anyone can make it, and the louder the better." All that explaining made him hungry. Benjamin decided it was time to eat. "Cookies," he said, and babysitter brought them. "Cake," he said, and out it came. Waffles, burgers, milkshakes, fries. Babysitter gave him everything he wanted. Babysitter told him,
"This is fun."
Lots of fun plus lots of food equaled a suddenly sleepy boy. "That's enough," babysitter Benjamin said. "I think I'm ready to go to bed."
9:05 Earth time, babysitter said. "Programming tells me it's time for fun."
"No," said Benjamin. "I want to go to bed," but babysitter wouldn't take no for an answer.
The trouble with you, Benjamin McFadden, is that you are no fun. Humans get tired, but robots do not. I will build fun robots. Fun must be had. Games, said babysitter. Games are fun. Books, said babysitter. Books are fun. Music is fun. And food is fun. And all the robots answered. Wow, look at all those robots that the babysitter robot made. Oh my goodness. Look at them go. They're doing all kinds of things. But Benjamin McFadden didn't think it was fun now. He only wanted to go to bed. He tried to put babysitter's programming back, but somehow that only made things worse. Fun, 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 fun time, babysitter said. Fun time, fun time, fun, 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 fun. Oh boy, now he doesn't want fun and babysitter does. Benjamin McFadden called for help. Babysitter helpline, a lady answered. Benjamin tried to explain what was wrong. I don't understand, the lady frowned. Our company's robots are very reliable. Benjamin confessed that he'd opened the bag. That is very serious, the lady told him. You should never open up your babysitter's bag. I know that now, groaned Benjamin McFadden. But how can I get my babysitter under control? The lady from the babysitter helpline exclaimed, babysitter robots have an ultimate password which restarts their original program. Once the original program restarts, your robot ought to function normally again. But I don't know any ultimate password. Just a minute, the lady said. We should have it on file. Yes, here it is. Okay, I don't know if they have it, but I hope so. But before the lady could tell him the password, babysitter took the phone away. Fun, said babysitter. Fun, 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 fun. And Benjamin McFadden was on his own. Benjamin tried every password he knew to get his babysitter under control. Abracadabra! Open sesame! Rumpelstiltskin! Toasted cheese! Babysitter kept on building robots. Babysitter kept saying, fun, 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 fun! Oh my goodness. Benjamin tried the names of planets, the names of all the planets, moons, the names of the stars and the constellations, and the capital cities of Earth and Mars. But nothing seems to be working. He was starting on comets and asteroids when babysitter suddenly snatched Fantastic, his cat, who's a robot too, it looks like. Put down my kitten, yelled Benjamin McFadden, and grabbed hold of Fantastic. You put him down, babysitter, or you know what I'll do? I'll tell my parents on you. Parents, said babysitter. Everything stopped. Parents, said the other robots, looking around. Parents, said Benjamin McFadden. Parents. Uh-oh, what's going on? And of course, that was the ultimate password. It worked. Look, everything stopped. Babysitter's original program restarted. 12:20 Earth time, babysitter said. You ought to be in bed now, Benjamin McFadden. Fantastic and Benjamin went to bed. It wasn't easy to fall asleep because babysitter was taking all the robots apart. Babysitter put all the pieces back and cleaned up after all the fun. Ooh. Benjamin McFadden was still awake when his mother and father came home in their ship. How did it go? He heard them ask. Babysitter's programming must have been slow because Babysitter's answer was a long time coming. My memory tells me there is nothing to report. Benjamin McFadden is an excellent child. He could hear everything that the babysitter said. His parents looked into Benjamin's room, but Benjamin pretended to be asleep. They tiptoed over to kiss his forehead. Then they tiptoed out again. Benjamin McFadden sat up in bed. What a weird night, he said to Fantastic. That's when Fantastic answered. Vaughn! Oh no! Did it reprogram him? I don't know, but he seemed to remember. I hope everything works out for him. So that's the story by Timothy Bush about the baby robot, the babysitter robot who went crazy. So that's because of what Benjamin McFadden did. I have a robot here who's going to help us find the letter R. Here is my robot. And I believe some of the buttons on this robot need a little repair too, just like the one in the story needed some help. This one does too. If you look at the letters around the outside, you'll see that they are red, most of them. And we're going to put them inside the robot to get this guy working the way he should. So we need to find the letter R, uppercase R or lowercase R, to help us out. So let's get started and see what we can do here. The first one, if you see an R, you can put your thumb up and maybe move your arms like a robot. Is that the letter R? Why, yes it is. Thumbs up and move like a robot. Next one, is that the letter R? No, it's the letter B. Let's try the next one. Is that the letter R? Yes, it's a lowercase r. Move like a robot. Is that the letter R? Yes, that's a lowercase r. Move like a robot. And we have one here. Is that the letter R? No, be careful. That line goes down further. That's the lowercase n. I don't want to put that on our robot. Is that the letter R? No, it is the letter X. How about down here? Do I have the letter R? No, I don't. This is the letter Q, so I'm gonna leave that there. I have this one. Is that the letter R? Yes, it's a lowercase r. Move like a robot. And then I have another one. Is that the letter R? Yes, it is the uppercase R. I'll put there and I'll move like a robot. Now all of these are red, but I have one that is different. I have more red and less blue, but let's check out this one. Is that the letter R? It is! Move like a robot. He's fixed, ready to go. So there's Mr. Robot with a letter R, and the sound for R goes, R says R, R says R. Every letter makes a sound, and R says R. All right, I have something else for the letter R. It's rhyming.
Rhyming are words that sound the same at the end, like pie, I. They rhyme. So let's see if I can show you some rhyming that I have here. Right there's another robot. And I have some pictures in a basket, or some objects in a basket, that should rhyme with what I have on the robot. Let's take a look at what we see. I have a boat, a dog, a bee, a moon, star, something blue, cat, bell, and snake. So what things are going to rhyme? Well, I'll hold something up and let's see if we can figure it out. I have a tree. What rhymes with tree? Tree boat, tree dog, or tree bee? It is tree bee! So I'm gonna put that together. That's a rhyme, tree and bee. Let's try another one. I'm gonna go with car. What rhymes with car? Car moon, car star, or car ball? Excuse me, blue. Car moon, car star, or car blue. The match is car star. That's the rhyme. Next, I have a hat. What rhymes with hat? Hat cat, hat bell, or hat snake? It is hat cat. That's my rhyme, hat and cat. I have another one. This is a goat. What rhymes with goat? Goat boat, goat dog. It is goat boat. Next, I have a shoe. What rhymes with shoe? Shoe moon, shoe blue. It's shoe blue. That's my rhyme. Then I have a cake, kind of cupcake, cake. So what rhymes with cake? Cake bell, cake snake. It's cake, snake. Then I have a frog. What rhymes with frog? Frog dog, frog bell, frog moon. It's frog dog. Next, I have a shell. What rhymes with shell? Shell moon, shell bell. It's shell bell. And the only one I have left is a spoon. So which one doesn't have a partner? It's moon, spoon. Those are our rhymes. We have, excuse me, goat boat, frog dog, bee tree, spoon moon, star car, blue shoe, cat hat, bell shell, snake cake. We've got it. Let's see if we can write the letter R. So we don't forget how to do that. You can do it in the air with me, like this. Line goes down, come around, kick it out. That's a diagonal line. The line goes down, come back on the same line, make a hook. Line goes down, come around, kick it out. Lowercase, line goes down and come back up on the same line. Let's see if we could do it again. One more time, you do it in the air. Line goes down, come around, and kick it out. If you don't make a diagonal line and you forget it, it will be the letter P. We don't want that. The line goes down. Remember to come back on the same line and then make the hook. Okay, if you do your R like this,
That's not the way you're supposed to make it, because I made a straight line across and I didn't even come back on the same line. So try to remember to come back on the same line. There we go. I have a shape that I'd like to show you that begins with the letter R, and that shape is a rectangle. A rectangle. This is a rectangle. A rectangle has two long sides and two short sides. Ricky Rectangle is my name. My four sides are not the same. Some are short, some are long. Hear me sing my happy song. Ricky Rectangle is my name. My four sides are not the same. Some are short, some are long. Hear me sing my happy song. You have to be careful because this is a square, and a square confuses people sometimes. They think it's the same as a rectangle. A square has four sides, but this is Sammy's square. Sammy's sides are all the same. I'm Sammy Square, and my sides are the same. All around the edge. Remember, a rectangle has two long sides and two short sides. I'm gonna show you. Here are some pictures of squares. All the sides are the same. Here are some pictures of rectangles. There are two long sides and two short sides. Two long sides, two short sides. Two long sides, two short sides. Two long sides, two short sides. Those are rectangles. Another one that begins with an R is this one. Sometimes it will be called a diamond, but we can call it a rhombus, and that has diagonal lines. Diagonal, slide like a sliding board, and they go like that. So there's two shapes, rectangle and rhombus. Rectangle and rhombus that begin with R. I'm going to make something that begins with the letter R. I'm going to use the shape rectangle, and I'm going to make a robot. Ooh, a robot. Well, how can I do this? Well, let's take a look and make sure I'm using all rectangles. You can see that one. That is my largest rectangle. It has two long sides and two short sides. And I'm going to put another rectangle to keep it all together and make a robot. Now I'm looking for my smallest rectangle. This is the largest one. This is the smallest one. I'm going to put that one right here because I want you to be able to see it. Oops, we lost it. Hold on. It's flying away. Guess it wants to go to Saturn like in the story Mommies and Daddies went to Saturn. There we go. It's so little. Now I'm going to put another rectangle, two long sides. Excuse me, these are the long sides. These are the short sides. And I'm gonna put that on the top. Wow. And there's my top. Now I need two on the side for arms. Two long sides, two short sides. And there's one there. And then I have another one for the other side. And he just needs some legs. This is my rectangle robot. And I have two rectangles for his legs. One here. I'll clip that.
and one here. I'll clip that. You can see how I'm doing it. Then you can decorate it and put a face on it. Or you can make a robot, maybe fantastic like we saw in the story, by using boxes. So you can go like this or like this. A robot would be like this. You can put it that way. You can use pipe cleaners. And you can make your own robot, or you can make it look like the Cat Fantastic. And you just need a few extra things like this to help you for maybe its neck. And the robot can go this way. And then you have something that was similar to what we saw in the story. So be creative, use your imagination, and you can make a robot too. Well, I'll see you next time. Have fun with your robot.